About 40 years ago, and I'm not the first doctor in the family. It was my father who was instrumental in bringing this pathology lab in 1949. That's also the year I was born. He died in 1977. At that point of time, I was a lecturer in Armed Forces Medical College in Pune. So I had to take over the lab almost in an emergency. But I would like to add that the spirit of all of you was also there in me at that time. My father ran this lab for about 28 years, and I've already run it for about 39 years now. So we were seeing about 30 patients a day in 1977. And today I would like to inform you that we see over 50,000 patients in a single day. We run about 175 labs all over India, 1,600 collection centers. I am the person who brought franchising in healthcare in the world. And what do we franchise out? We franchise out collection centers. And the collection center also was, you know, born, the franchising model was born because people, you know, the landlords would not give a future tenant like me 150 or 250 square feet, because they told me on my face, they said, "Dr. Lal, we can make out that you are somebody, you know, whom we'll never be able to get out of this place." And they were right. So I had to devise something in my mind that how do I crack this business, because in my profession, and fortunately for me, every patient doesn't want to see my face. There's nothing much to see in any case. So I could, you know, the samples were already coming to us from places like All India Institute and LNJP and many big hospitals, etc., etc. So I knew that in my profession, we can transport the blood, and if we can crack this of taking this blood sample somewhere else and bringing it down to the lab in correct, you know, temperature kind of surroundings, then we were there. But I'd like to tell you that year before last, in December, we went public. And it was one of the most successful IPOs ever recorded. So our share price started from 550, and within 24 hours it had crossed 50%, and today we are sitting pretty at more than double of that. So I would like to get on with the business now at hand. And I would like to say that the government of India also is, you know, trying to say and, you know, help all of you in make in India. Now this make in India, I'm not going to go through all what everybody else knows, but I would just like to sensitize you to the make in India kind of a problem. Of course, there is infrastructure. You ask me outside Delhi if I want to set up a lab. You know, there are 12-hour power cuts. Our machines gave way. They could not test the material properly because even the portable, you know, water which goes into the RO plant and then into the Kent plants we were using at that time. So they were not, you know, able to give the analytical grade RO water. I mean, that's the down reality. But you and I, because we are born Indians and we all can, you know, think about something. So I want you to consider this thing very, very carefully, and that is that how will you beat China? China has already entered in your backyard. Most of the Indians don't seem to be minding it. But I am one chap who really minds it, and I hope all of you will also mind it. That do not let the Chinese in. I would much rather see all of you go to China and set up your business there rather than coming here. Geo News, etc., etc., I read every day. I read about Jack Ma or Jill Bop, etc., etc. But the fact of the matter is that you must pull up your pants and, you know, stop this nuisance from happening in India. So that is where you all come in. I would also like to say that Indians, you know, by nature, we fear failure. So two things I'd like to say here, that, you know, the best thing is, if you look at the government of India, and day before yesterday, I was really sad to read that Air India is the world's third worst airline. And as if to prove themselves, you know, right, there has been a death in my family, so, you know, my cousins are arriving, they came from Australia. They flew by the Dreamliner, but the condition in which the Dreamliner from Melbourne to Delhi direct flight, because they want to take the direct flight, is impossible to state here. And these are just three-year-old planes, they can't look after them. And the reason is that in India, because nobody wants to fail, the best thing is to do nothing. You don't do anything, you'll never fail. So whatever may happen to you, don't say ever that you have given up. I am a standing example in front of you. During my days, the import duty on our instrumentation was 90%. And with getting some signatures here and there, it could be brought down to 60%, but we have paid all that kind of duty and we are standing in front of you. Also, the secret of success is actually there is no secret. And I'm not saying it, it is the world famous, you know, woman entrepreneur by the name of Oprah Winfrey who said this. Just keep doing your work better than the next man and you are there. Do your work with all your research, planning and action. Indians are very good at only research and planning. In action, you know, they say ki ab to ye nahi hota. And there are hundreds of sad stories which you hear. So you must go through the full loop. Also, Indians are very, very innovative, which means that all of us believe in Jugaad. But let me tell you that Jugaad should not come first and then the real thing follows, as we saw in the demonetization which Faiz is going to talk about. So within overnight, you know, the new notes had already come in, more black money was caught, in which more, you know, new 2000 notes were also, you know, caught, etc. So all this is Jugaad, but please stay away from there. So I would advise you and I would request you to do good ethical business and beat them at their own game. I'm talking about the Chinese again. Thank you very much.